This is Curlian with episode 8 of my Let's Play Total War Warhammer as the Orks, or Greenskins, on very hard difficulty. Last time, we smacked down Eckendorf with one army, as we have started to actually fight it out. Now, I have a decision to make. This has a lot of room for expansion, and I do need to spend about two turns, maybe? Replenishing, but I lost one of my units, so I could, in theory, build that here in order to rebuild orcs. But I kind of think it's so close to my other region. I guess I do have a little ways to go. I just don't think it's worth building one so close to here. So we're going to build other things. We're going to build that. We're going to go with money. We're going to go with public order. And the last thing we're going to do is... What is a beast lair? No, you're going to build the priest thing. We have 29% corruption here. We need to get that corruption in order.
The tribe's ready!
Now you... We're going to go ahead and move you... down to, like, right here. Now, we're not taking corruption yet, no. It's not corrupted enough for us to take corruption. Now, there is border princes in there, but I'm not ready to take that. So we're going to bring this guy down. Now, I have a Wah and nothing to do with it. So we're going to go ahead and send our Wah to Zvorak. It'll explore ahead for us and see what's here. We do have a small force here at Karak Ingar. Now, your Wa apparently has left you. Wait, that's not you. This is the guy I'm talking about. His Wa does seem to be gone too. I'm gonna come to here. And he is force marching. He'll take him a while to get there because he is way back. His Wa. It is time for you to be sent out. What is the furthest south region that I know of? Now I'll send you here. It doesn't matter if he gets there or not. Not really. Okay. Barakvar. Ogre walls. Build walls. Oh, we already have walls. Then we'll build... Don't care about building that yet. Build that up. Then we'll build this. And... Which means let's take that away. Now can I build it? No, I need 7,500. So we're not going to be able to build that. So we'll build this. And doing some growth. Build Barrack far up the rest of the way. Let's just quickly jump to other regions and see what else might need it. I'm here. Money. That's good. I'm pretty sure that's the only place it needs money. But you never know. Yeah, I could build growth down here, but I don't really need it. Good, good. Not so good. This can get broken down, and we could... Not so good. Now this is gonna drop corruption, which will help a little bit. We already have the +2 obedience going on. Well, we'll drop that soon, because we're not going to necessarily be marching all the way back here to build up our Black Orc. So when they're built up on him, we'll be able to get rid of that. Okay, so that's the only... We did one battle. It went pretty well. Took a level 4 region. And he gets a thing.
Let's go.
Ard Lads. Getting his due, since he's really using the big dudes at this point, orcs, and we want to give them the buffs to really succeed. And I did expect more armies, so they may be further south, or they may be on that side of the mountain. We'll have to watch and see if we find any coming out of this. Let's go ahead and end the turn. We have a character with a skill. Advisor. Oh, you know what? We have dudes that need to go places. Ew. Let's go find our advisors and make sure we're all moving in the right direction. Okay, you. You provide a bunch of extra money. So I actually just want you to come out and hang outside of Black Crag. Let's see who else. Now you. You need to get better. So you, I am going to send up the air. And then our last dude, we'll go to there. And now we'll end our turn. We have to make sure we get our agents to where they're going to be useful. There goes the Wah. Get a couple more, get a region out of him maybe. The ability to double your army is pretty amazing. Are they going to ask for peace already? No. Now they may sell an army across the way, and if so, we'll deal with it. I can send Waz after it if nothing else. And I have an army walking away. So we have 14 settlements. The momentum shifts as the Orc realm expands, the doors quail, the Empire shudders, even the forces of chaos stutter as the green tide rises. And now is the time to bring outlying territories into Grimgor's clutches. And that gives us a ton of money, which we get to spend. We're aiming for 18 settlements next, which will come very soon. You, get moving. You need to get out of force march, first of all. We are going to just move to there, and we need to actually raid. Oh, we need 50%. Oh well, I guess we're not gonna raid. We'll just come over here. Prepare to take Karak Ansgar. That used to be a good orky realm, and it got stopped. This we can expand. We definitely have to wait at least a turn for that to get taken care of before we can march. And I'm not sure I'm going to march south or if I will turn and come around to here. I can't really take them out till after I get an agent action off on them. You're going over there. Where are my agents? You. You need to hurry up. You just need to go over here. Okay. You can't do anything yet. You've moved. You. Go ahead and come this way. We're also making sure that we have an army down here by sending them this route, in case they decide to get fancy and go around us. Your Waz moving. You'll attack next time. You're moving slowly, but surely you will eventually get there. Okay. Nika and Anthony just come over this way. Next turn we'll deploy him. And that will hopefully improve public order too by having his stuff there. Of course this guy may be providing some public order. And yeah, that will go away. I would really like to move you into there, but oh well. So let's see what I can do in Black Crag. Go ahead and build our walls. Does this provide public order? Nope, just lots of reduction in corruption, which not be terrible, but that's expensive. We need places with that in other areas. Okay, you're happy enough. We will make the money. That's all I'll do here for the moment. You are also falling happy enough. We're one turn away from our giant. And can't get anything that does money, so we'll skip it for now. Here. Can we do anything that makes money? No, but we could get that. That'd be good. Try to reduce corruption, because corruption is not good at all. We'll build that up. Can we build anything cool here? What is this? Oh, a beast lair. Eh, whatever. Nothing to build there at the moment. We could build our walls. Case, even if it's just to slightly damage someone should they come this way, that's worth doing. Not worth building that up anymore. Money. And that's all of our money. So we didn't get any fights this turn. But that'll take us to the end phase. Now that goblin sack may be an utter waste. I may turn around and come back and get all iron, another awesome iron or black orc army. Keep on calling them iron orcs, but you know, black orcs. Like, we really don't want to fight you. It's a really bad idea for us. Okay, here comes an army. Ooh, they went for my wa. Then they stopped. Well, the Wa survived. Winds of magic. Obedience. We'll keep them sweet. We have plenty of money. Okay, you. I'm going to start off with a fight over in Kerak and Gazar. Pretty small force, but we'll fight it just to get some practice with our goblins. We'll do this on that unit. I want to try out the Goblin Fanatics. So, let's go ahead and fight this. Now, we have a lot of ranged. So, we're going to see if they'll come to us first. And if not, we'll make them pay for it. I kind of doubt they'll come to us, but you never know. We do have two rock lavas. They're not nearly as fun as the other one, but for now they work. The Doom Diver is just a lot of fun. Part of me thinks I should have switched to my main armies to Doom Divers, but you know. As it is, my Ozog is still building for another couple turns. That giant's not going to be fast either. So, how long do you want to sit there twiddling your thumbs before you move out? Okay, so we have poison attacks. We're going to go ahead and start our deployment. Because that's good magic. Okay, so we're going to first of all just grab everyone. And move them back. I don't want to fight with the hill. So we're going to come over here. We're going to start by putting our two rock lavas way up in the front. That'll give us good range. Now there's a decent chance they set up like over here. But we can deal with that if they did. Now we're going to have a line of archers. Maybe put directly behind them. And then a line of our goblins. And these have the ability. Spinning loons. Sent mad by drinking fungus brew, night goblin fanatics are released from their mobs as a twirling cyclone of destruction armed with a large ball and chain. It's a 12-second vortex. As soon as they're in range. We are definitely going to try that out because it sounds awesome. We'll put our general right here. Nice and safe in the middle, and then we'll start the battle. So you two, we're going to go ahead and start firing right at these crossbowmen. You start firing at these crossbowmen. Because the crossbows are, to be honest, the scariest thing they have. We aren't exactly the best at dealing with it. Some decent damage in the first one on that unit, not so much on the other one. Okay, when I go ahead and pull these guys over to here. And we're gonna grab these ints in the fort now. Now you, do you have any spells worthwhile? You have one. Might as well cast right there. Oh, there they are. There are my fanatics. So I don't have to do anything to set them off. That's pretty good. You guys start firing at these guys back there as our line is just moving forward. Go ahead and do our spell right here. You guys come into here. You guys come right into here. You fire back here. And we have swarmed them. Our archers have done pretty well. 29 kills, and 13 here, 22 there. Well, that was a fun little battle. Now they're goblins, so we're gonna end the battle before they kill themselves. We didn't really take any casualties. We lost 53. We'll regain, but that seemed to be pretty consistent across the army. So we should pretty much have that back after camping out one turn in this city. Now this city is part of an area that we can actually get to because we're orcs. So this army is just going to jump to the other side and work on those other two cities. That'll be great. I'm not entirely sure how well this one will do against the fortified city. It has archers, but maybe more archers would have been good in this army. Because really, I think the archers are better than the generic night goblins. Although I will say that the fanatics are awesome. They did fun things. Now they can come back and bite me like crazy because vortexes can go all over the place. But they worked out pretty well. Well, a couple losses. Nothing that goblins would care about. We're gonna loot and occupy. You know, if I knew that the... Oh, we have a dude here. That's... whatever. Money! Okay, so they do have basic walls. and a size 2 settlement. So if we look at that, that is a pretty decent garrison. They don't have any of the really cool troops, though. They have some knights, but we can deal with knights. You need a spell, a damage-y spell, which you can't get. Oh, we're going to start you on the spell route, because spells will be fun. Okay. You? Go right for that guy. Oh, Matorka's got burnt to the ground? I didn't want you to do that. Ah, you suck. So this army is actually going to come back here and spend goblin lives to get Matorka back up and going. Oh well. What can you send an orc to do?
Gulp, send me to battle.
Okay. Keep running. Let's go on. You'll move on your own accord. You're fine. You did do a decent job on them. You're going to end up getting ganked, but I don't really care. Okay, you're going to come to right here.
Let's go.
We're making 95.77. We gained a whole 30 gold. Way to go, dude. Okay, we're one turn away from all of this. We are getting pluses, so he is helping the region like I hoped he would. Are you helping the region at all? War banner doesn't matter. Okay, good. So when you leave, it's not gonna matter. Maybe, well, although... No, that doesn't matter. Okay, so you should be able to leave here without it mattering at all. Really though, I think I'm just gonna send you to go fight your first thing. Okay. Over here. Money. Because there's nothing else to build, boss hold. I want that to move up. So we'll stop there for this region. Here, we have plenty of public order. We're good. Oh, you know what? This is just trolls. I need that. Which means I need 15,000. Well, we'll build that next turn. We'll save our money. We could easily build another army if we want. I'm not sure I'm gonna bother, but we could definitely do that. To build another army or to not build another army? They have two stacks coming. But I have things to deal with that. Okay. Our wall is destroyed. We have growth issues. So, how are you looking? Oh, build that up. I'm gonna move you to Iron Rock, where you will provide bonuses for a turn. And, curiosity. I can't build them anyways. We need one of these. I kind of like Doom Divers. It's just fun. But I don't think I'm going to build them. You. Continue north. Okay. Here. We need to go bust some heads.
Nasty
You're gonna stay right there. That's fine. How are we looking here? That's a lot of penalties. Where are all these penalties coming from? Negative 5 from corruption. Ow. We're gonna have a revolt there. But I wanna come and crush these two armies first. You're very crushable.
Absolutely not.
You have a lot of those.
Absolutely not.
Okay, so your army. You're getting that. Now I'm kind of tempted to hire an army here. For the sole purpose of dealing with stuff. But really, it would have to be back here. And if I'm not willing, and do I want it to be a good stack? Or would it just be a eh? Who would I hire if I was going to hire another lord? We have a level 2 dude. I'm an honorable guy. Eh? Campaign line of sight, it's not terrible. He already has a point to spend. We can definitely afford another good stack. Do I want to spend the money? Don't really know that I do.
This is my land. I'm off.
Now you.
I'm special.
I am going to have you come stand by him. We have a revolt here, I'll deal with the revolt. Let me rephrase that. When we have a revolt there, I will deal with the revolt. I need to deal with the armies first. Okay. How long is it going to take us to get our giant? Five turns. Arg. You may come up to Ackendorf and deal with that rebellion. Okay, let's go ahead and end the turn. My goblin dude is almost there too. Getting very close to having our invasion force ready. He's like pissing off the guys there. Whatever.
Can you feel it? From the north it comes. The tendrils of chaos spread south, tainting the lands. And with it, the warriors of chaos march. We must ready ourselves. The war is coming. But who has brought the warring tribes together? What manner of champion holds that power?
Eh, we'll deal with it. So there's more chaos invasion. We have raiding. More raiding. Oh, so much raiding. Okay, you. Come up here. I'm gonna deploy you because I believe that's what I need to do for my thing, right? Yep, here. Deploy a goblin big boss. He is deployed. He may not survive it, but I don't really care about that. Run, little dude. Good, we'll take Meriden's. Now this is not actually a good stack, so I don't know if I'm gonna bother. Oh, Meriden's is... That's not a small thing. Huh. Well, we'll see how well you would stack up there before we move on. Okay.
The tribe's ready.
If you go to right here. That's good because I need to raid. Raid in camp. And we're gonna go to raiding. Oh, we can't.
Let's go.
They're still backing each up, and he's raiding. He's making no money. It's like the worst raiding ever. Is it because this place, Matoka? It's a waste of time. Get out of that. Just cross the river.
Dog wants me over there.
Okay. We're looking at two armies, both of which. Are not that amazing. They do have cavalry where I don't, which does give them a little bit more versatility. Okay. We have 10,000 gold to spend. Our chaos corruption is going down. Kind of like it to go down further. If I do that, it would bring chaos corruption down, but it wouldn't necessarily help anything else. We'll build that there, and we'll sit happy. Over here, I'm gonna build that. We're gonna build that. Why not? We'll build that. Over here, money. Eckendorf is going to have a revolt. But our chaos corruption issues, in theory, are going to go down. We need to move that up too. Get as much chaos reduction as we can. It just becomes hard to hold stuff if you don't deal with chaos corruption quickly. So I believe that's everything I can do. We'll end the turn. And we'll see what these two guys do. Eventually we'll have to deal with the vampire corruption too. That's going to be a pain in the butt. There will be a lot of attrition when we do that. But we'll have much better stacks. Okay. Are you going to take the region? Because that would make me happy. Nope. Because why would you conquer something? That would be like improving your nation. It would also leave you to be plucked, but still. Varg Bjornling. Oh, that's a problem. Oh, that's a giant problem. That's a lot of them. So, you know, we have to look at Gitznik. Black Mountains. Yeah, it's fine. I'm gonna have a revolt there.
Here we go. Move it.
Now they'll see. Zogin, get him! On the way. Now!
Now, this is kind of a ridiculous fight, but what the heck, we'll fight it. I kind of feel like I brought truly overwhelming force to this fight, but that's fine. It's how you actually win these things is overwhelming force. And it'll get good experience for our greenskin allies. And it will take care of one of these armies. Oh my goodness, there are so many frickin'. I will be building armies to deal with that. Chaos has come to shore. I don't think they've declared war on me yet, but that many don't show up for nothing. But we'll be able to throw waws at them. Lots and lots of waws. I expected one or two Border Prince armies. I did not expect four or five Bjornling armies. What the heck are the Humies doing in the north? Well, we're gonna go and start deployment. This is a cruddy battlefield. Allies are coming from this side, so that's fine. We're gonna put both of these here. We're going to do a line of our archers. Top of this mountain. Let's get a little thinner. We have the boys getting set up. And leading the pack is, of course, him. Now we have two cavalry. And our trolls, and I'm gonna put those on the back. They don't really have much cavalry that will be important to this, but we do have some fanatics that can go out if they get near our archers. Okay, so can you shoot any of them? No. So you gotta go up to there. You're gonna come up to here. You're gonna come up to here. You gotta come to here. Trolls are gonna come to here. Okay. You guys start firing out there. Where's Grimgor? Grimgor. Go right into that. We're bringing our. You guys, come deal with them. I don't think this is going to go very well for my guys. You start firing at him. You need to get it back. You're not a fighter. Too many dudes. It's not even worth fighting that. They're just gonna run away before we can get to anything. We'll just cause everything else to run. Go for that. Go for there. I don't think this battle went particularly well. Go kill them, Grimgor. Come kill this. I think that's pretty much over, other than these. Yeah. It would have been easier not to have all that stuff, because it just made it hard to figure out which unit was which. That was a decisive victory. I could have tried to chase them all down, but that was just not really worth it. We'll just auto-win a quick finish them off battle. Took a little bit of damage, but not much. We lost 90 men to defeat 900, 850. So, not terrible. The trolls both kill in the 40s. So at least they're pulling their weight compared to what a lot of the other guys did. A lot of my Iron Orcs got in the 40s. Pretty good. My archers didn't do a whole lot this battle, but that's okay. My boar boys did like nothing. These units are just obnoxious to me. We have nothing that can catch them. Basically, we just need to shell them with our cannons and hope to kill them all. This one must have ran out of bullets and charged in or something. Obviously, it was not a wise choice. We really did not need to bring this army in. We eat them. You're dead.
I'm special.
Are we at war with these dudes? I'm at war with them. Okay, well, time to send some Waws that way. So, where are you, Waw? You have now have a target. Go kill that.
What?
Now you have gained a rank up. It's very sadly your second. Okay, you. Okay. Now you. I need you to get up here. And I'm going to hire another army. I think we're making enough, and we're definitely conquering. So we're going to actually hire and build a decent army. It's going to be expensive. We'll do this phlegmatic guy. Yeah, look at that. Our the amount we're paying increased greatly. He is going to be Root Marcher. But we need to build up his army fast. Now, part of me would love to give him Black Orcs, but I think I'm just going to go with Biggins. Lots of big ones to begin with. Then we'll do a bunch of archers and stuff. Now, what makes money? Because all I'm going to do is something that makes money this time. Now, that would make money. We could only increase one. We'll do Misty Mountain. It's further away from possible attack. Okay, nothing that makes money here. Nothing that makes money here, but it would really improve my garrison to the point where... But it doesn't make money. I kind of want to focus on money this turn. Money. Repair that. Repair that. We are so getting a revolt next turn. More money. That's a pretty amazing garrison. Okay, that's everything we're doing. Now, they dropped armies here and back here. So that may be the only army that's actually coming at me currently. We are at war with them, though, so we'll need to deal with it. It's almost enough that I would consider asking for peace, accepting peace from the Border Kings, so that I could, Ard lads. So that I could deal with it. Are you raiding?
Absolutely not.
You are. That's weird. I guess you're raiding my land, so whatever.
The time's ready.
You go sit in the city. Gives you a little better recovery. Not that you really need it, but... Okay. I think I said that like 40 times. We'll do the end turn and then we'll probably just end the video. It'll be a little shorter than some others, but I think that my videos tend to go a tad longer than they might need to. So aiming for more like 50 minutes instead of 60 might be good. Of course, I do that and still end up taking an hour half the time. There's Von Karsten. He has like no troops. Okay. So, 1800 for peace. I'm going to agree. Because I have bigger fish to fry right now. And they're going to get wrecked anyways. Now, if I lose Karak and Gazar right now, it's not terrible. But if I lose half my south, that would be a problem. So, we're going to deal with the Bjornling. That would be 3 stacks coming to my lands. We have a Wa. Demantief. We're just gonna stomp everything anyways. Ain't gonna be no reason to route. Okay, you are growing an army. You. I'm pretty sure that this building is not ready yet. Nope. Okay. So, that leaves us with a crud ton of armies to deal with.
The boys are restless. Let's go.
You? I want you to go fight. Or, Anse, I want you to go fight. That army. Grimgor. Your horde. I'm gonna do that one. You know, Azarg. I need you to come fight. Time to go slaughter some people. You can come pick up your giants later. Okay, Grimgor. And Force March. Okay, you. How are you looking in this region? Not very good. We need to buff that. Why is it so bad? Those defenses. If I do that, it would take turns to get out. We need to just force march you to go fight.
It's good. Yes, yes.
If you have to come back and take some of this stuff, we will. We're almost certainly gonna have to. I could bring Azog that way. Okay, Azog. You gotta come this way. Okay, we're sending our army south. We're gonna deal with this. Let's end the turn. We actually can match them stack for stack, and our troops are way better. With the exception of possibly my generic auto-resolve stack, which should beat them auto-resolve. Well, strangely. Oh, go ahead and do that. We kind of wrecked them, and our WAD did not get destroyed. We have a rebellion, that's fine. Okay. You.
I'll crush them all.
I think not. Cease.
Now's the time. Gulk, send me to battle.
Need to be in normal sense.
Go in.
He's getting a lot of recovery. That kind of sucks. I'll bring you this way. Because they're moving all over. We need to go and deal with this. Now, some of those places actually have a decent chance of defeating them. You need to kind of build on the move, as it were. A rock lava. Two rock lavas. Okay. You come this way. We just spend so much time conquering this region, but that's fine. We can deal with this. Now I think over here is where the rebellion is. Nope. Okay, where did the rebellion occur? There. Black Mountain. Except I don't see a rebellion there. That's kind of weird. Okay, you. Come that way. Okay.
Asinine mortal!
Asinine mortal!
No, scum!
Never!
Okay, I think that's... No, I need to spend money. Anywhere that I can build defenses, I should. We'll build that up. Now I'll take my all the money. So we're gonna end the turn. Our finances are tanking a little. I was supposed to end the whole video. See, I get so caught up and then I don't. This time I'll try to remember. I really wanted to claim Matorka, but I can't really give up half an army. And the three turns of recovery at this point in time. I just got attacked by a ton, and I have to deal with it quickly. And then probably turn my attention back to the border princes. I really don't care if people don't trust me. They all declare war on me. I win. Thank you for running right at my auto-resolve army. Well, that just dealt with two of the stacks, pretty much. Get you. Savages. Eat them all. I will say, sometimes just running around with auto when at armies, we're just gonna occupy because it's ours. And you need to regrow because that did take a big out of you. But he basically just took out two of the stacks himself, which is pretty darn good. Now I'm thinking I don't need to do all this. But we're gonna go do it anyways. Okay, where are my hordes? You? I'm gonna target raid this dude.
Nasty magic,
ready. You.
On the way.
What is this? Oh, that's Zoof Bar. We'll deal with Zoof Bar eventually. You know what? I'm supposed to have a dude heading to Zoof Bar. What happened to my dude heading to Zoof Bar? There you are. Just come here. I almost forgot all about him. Now you. I kind of don't think I need you anymore. So walk back over here. Wait, no, never mind. There's going to be a rebellion here. I want you to be here for the rebellion. Once rebellion happens, we'll let it go for a turn or two, and then we'll snuff it out. Okay. You've gone as far as you can. I think that's everything. Let's go ahead and end the turn. We have a commandment in Southern Badlands, since we got this region back. Obedience and growth. We'll build that. And that, because apparently this region is endangered. And I can't build that. But I would really like to. Maybe next turn. Okay, we're gonna go to end the turn, I guess. Huh. Oh my goodness, I keep forgetting. Now up to an hour. I was going to end this 10 minutes ago. I'm deeply sorry. We will end the video this time. I just see things. I'm like, ooh, I need to do this real fast. Ooh, I need to do this real fast. And then I just keep going. It's a bad habit. One, I need to work on, you know, being more cognizant of the time. But we're gonna win here, and then we'll be good to go. Okay, we're gonna end the video here. Like and subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. As we are now defending our homelands. So, talk to you later. Adios.